Well, hello again and welcome everyone from all of us here at Calvary Chapel Hemet. Wherever you are, far or near, we just welcome you. And before we begin, let's go before the Lord in prayer. Father, we just come before you, Lord, in such grateful hearts. We ask you, Lord, that you would continue to draw us near to you, to refresh our minds and our hearts in your most precious word. We pray this in your name. Amen. Well, here we are as we're moving along, as we're traveling through this prayer of David's in the 23rd Psalm. Today we'll be looking at verse 5. And I've titled my sharing with you today according to this verse that says, "Come to the table." David's prayer continues on in this incredible chapter as he says, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over." Well, so far in the past weeks in this chapter, we have gone through the first four verses, which pretty much told us who our shepherd is, who he is in our lives, and also who we are as his sheep. He makes us to lie down in green pastures. He leads us beside those still waters. He restores our soul. He leads us onto his path of righteousness for his name's sake. And he walks us through all those dark valleys of life as he comforts us. And as I was meditating on these handfuls, so to speak, of words, it was an amazing blessing to me to realize that all the riches and the blessings that are poured into our lives just through this chapter. So much so that it caused me to want to just drop to my knees in praising God and thanking him for this incredible gift of the 23rd Psalms. And now, as we move on in verse 5, David's prayer continues on as he says, he prepares a table before me in the presence of our enemies, our adversaries, all those who are out there to attack us and get us, with Satan front row center. But on the other hand, at this table, we see the power and the might of our God. You know, for believers, this table for us it's the assurance of how our shepherd provides for us. It's where we find his abundance, his satisfaction, and his love. We are so blessed by this table. So if you're anything like me, you might have already asked yourself, why does he do this in the front of our enemies? Well, there's possibly many reasons why, but for me, I just saw a couple of them that I'd like to share with you. I think more than likely, possibly, so our enemies will see how in Christ we have victory. And also that our adversary, our enemy, would see the power of God, that he would see his protective love over us, over his sheep. And for me, I see a white, spotless tablecloth over this table in bold print where it says, "Beware, don't touch, these are my sheep." And if that was not enough, our shepherd anoints our head with oil. And as we've been told so many times, how much like those sheep we really are. And so just like those sheep, we tend to crumble when our adversary, our enemies, attack us. He attacks, we crumble. But our shepherd has thought of even that. He covers us. He anoints our head with oil. It's that oil that strengthens us deep within. The joy of the Lord then becomes our strength, and he brings that spirit of calm assurance into our lives. That's God's part. And as studiers of the Word, which I'm sure that you are, we know that throughout the Word of God, there's God's part, but also tucked in to those words is always our part. And for us right now, our part is to flee from the enemy, to draw nearer to God. That's where our protection will come from, his holy table that he has already prepared for us. And then our cup overflows. It becomes that cup of, that's full of contentment, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, all those beautiful fruits of the Spirit. We become content in our shepherd's care. You know, it's a contentment that should mark every person who claims to be a Christian, especially for those who call Christ their shepherd. It's a peace that will surpass all understanding. It'll take over and it'll control our lives as we become more surrendered to Christ. In Philippians chapter 4, Paul explains that peace to us, that peace that surpasses all understanding. And here we see this great man of God with intelligence, with wisdom, with spiritual discernment above and beyond most people. And yet even he had a difficult time explaining that peace to us. All he could say is that it surpasses all understanding. That's God's part. Our part is simply to trust him and to rest in the sweet promises of the 23rd Psalm. Father, we just thank you, Lord God. We praise you. We give you all the glory, and we ask that you help us to absorb our minds, our hearts, and our lives into the beauty of this prayer of David's. In your most precious name we pray, Lord. Amen. Well, goodbye now, my friends, and God bless you.